Hi everyone, welcome back to this video on how to create and customize ports in a Blazor diagram. Port is a special connection point of the node and allows creating connections with only those specific points. In this video, I am going to show you how to create and add ports to the nodes programmatically and dynamically. You will see how to add multiple ports, update port properties, and remove ports at runtime. Additionally, you will see how to customize the appearance and position of ports and interact between ports or nodes. First, I open an existing Blazor app, where I've added a Blazor diagram component with the basic properties. If you want to know how to create this Blazor WebAssembly app and add Syncfusion Blazor components to it, follow the video linked in the card above. I've also added a basic shape node to the diagram component. To know how to create nodes in different types of node shapes, refer to the video attached in the description below. Now, I will run this application to see the diagram component. The diagram canvas has been rendered with the defined node. Now, I am going to show you how to create a port programmatically. Inside the onInitialized method, I add the ports property by defining the diagram object collection class of the point port type and create a new port with the ID port 1. To position the port, I define the offset property. And set 1 on x-axis and 0.5 on y-axis. I also define the visibility property to display the port on the node. This visibility accepts 4 different options like visible, hover, connect, and hidden. Now I set to visible, as I want to display the port always on the node. You can see the port is added to the node. Using this port, you can connect the nodes. To demonstrate, I will copy this node and paste it adjacently. And I can draw a connector from this port and connect the adjacent node. Next, I will show how to create a port dynamically with a button click. I am going to use Syncfusion Blazor button, so let me import the button's namespace. And add the button component with the content add. As I said, a port can be added on button click. For that, I will add the onClick event with the event handler add port. I define the event handler. And within it, use the same logic I used before for creating a port. I then add this port to the ports collection object. When I click the Add button, a port is dynamically added to the node. Now, let's see how to add multiple ports at runtime. Within the Add Port event handler, I create 3 more ports using the same logic, with appropriate ID and offset values. Next, I add all these ports to the ports collection object. Check now, multiple ports are added to the node when I click the button. Next, I will show you how to update the properties of a port dynamically. To demonstrate, I add 1 more button component with the appropriate content and click event. To update the port dynamically, I create an instance for the diagram component and add a reference to it using the @ref property. As I plan to update the port's position on the update button click, I define the update port event handler. And call the beginUpdate method. I change the offset to 1 on the x-axis. and y-axis. Here, the index value represents the position of the port in the ports collection object. Finally, I call the endUpdate method. When I click the Update button, you will see the position of the node changed. Similarly, you can remove any port using the Remove method with the respective index. By default, a port is displayed at the center with respect to the offset position. That is, both the horizontal and vertical alignment is center. Apart from this position, it supports combinations of right, left, top, and bottom directions. Here the port is displayed in different horizontal and vertical alignments with offset 0, 0. Now, I would like to set the right bottom position with the offset 0, 0. Inside the onInitialized method, within the ports definition, I simply define the horizontal alignment property and set its value to the right and vertical alignment to the bottom. I also changed the offset to 0 on x-axis and y-axis. The port is now displayed in the right bottom position. Now let's see how to set the margin to the port. I define the margin property. And set its value to 20 in the top direction. See, the port is displayed with the defined margin. Next, you will see how to customize the appearance of the port. I define the style property and set the fill property to red, stroke color to black, and stroke width to 2. Here, the fill property applies background color to the port. Stroke color represents the border, and stroke width represents the border width. See, the port is rendered with the defined styles. The default shape of a port is square. Apart from this, the Blazor diagram also supports circle, X, and custom shapes. I will show you how to set a custom shape. I define the shape property and set its value to custom. As I am going to render a star-shaped custom port, I set the appropriate value to the path data property. The custom-shaped port is rendered. Finally, I will show you how to connect nodes using the ports. To demonstrate, I add one more node with the appropriate ID and style, and add it to the nodes collection object. Now, I am going to connect these two nodes by drawing a connector from the port of the first node. So, in the first node, I define the constraints property and enable the draw option along with the default port constraints. I can draw a connector from the port and connect the second node. Notice, the port remains fixed as I move the position of the attached node and the connector. But in the node-to-node connection, the connector keeps changing position when the attached node is moved. In this video, you have seen how to create a port programmatically and dynamically. You have also seen how to create multiple ports and update properties of ports dynamically. Additionally, you saw how to position ports and customize their appearance, as well as how to draw a connector using the port. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use all our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.